Welcome back to another tutorial video in differential calculus. I will discuss locating critical points and the maxima and minima. So first, what is a critical point? So critical points are points on the graph of a function where the derivative is equal to zero. So if you get your first derivative and then you equate it to zero, then you can determine the critical point. So let us examine the case of the function y is equal to x cubed minus 3x squared minus 9x plus 20. And let's locate the critical points on this function. So we have y is equal to x cubed minus 3x squared minus 9x plus 20. So according to definition, that the critical point is points on the graph where the first derivative, okay, is equal to 0. So the first step you would do is get the first derivative of your function. So we have y prime is equal to 3x squared minus 6x minus 9. And then equate the first derivative to 0. So the first derivative will become 0. So we have 3x squared minus 6x minus 9. And then solve for x using this function. So try to simplify it first. We could multiply 1/3. Okay. And our function would become 0 is equal to x squared minus 2x minus 3. Let's continue. So algebraically, we can factor. So this would be 3. That would be 1. So therefore, this is negative and that would be positive. Okay, in order for us to produce this trinomial. So therefore, we can already see here, solving algebraically, that x would be equal to negative 1 and x would be equal to 3. So we have two values of x wherein you will find or you have the critical points. So first, at x is equal to negative 1, what would be your y? Okay, so go back to your original function. Y is equal to x cubed. Okay, x cubed minus 3x squared minus 9x plus 20. So you have y, substitute x is equal to negative 1. So we have negative 1 squared minus 3 times, or negative 1 cubed. Okay, negative, this is cubed, so that would be cubed. And then this will be negative 1 squared minus 9 times negative 1 plus 20. So y would be equal to negative 1. This would be negative 1 squared, so that would be positive. And times negative 3, so negative 3 pa rin. And then this would be plus 9, and then plus 20. So here we have negative 1 minus 3, so that is negative 4 plus 9, so that is 5. And then plus 20, so y is equal to 25. So therefore, one of the critical points is negative 1, 25. Okay? So next, we have number 2, x is equal to 3. Okay, so again, go back to your function, y is equal to x cubed minus 3x squared minus 9x plus 20. And then substitute x is equal to 3 and solve for y. So we have 3 cubed minus 3 times 3 squared minus 9 times 3 plus 20. So we can see here that this is 3 cubed and this will ultimately be 3 cubed. So both of them will cancel out. And this will be 27, negative 27 plus 20. So we'll have y is equal to negative 7. So therefore, the second of the critical points is 3 and negative 7. Now, let's say I use an online grapher to graph my function. So this is the function that we have solved earlier. This is y is equal to x cubed minus 3x squared minus 9x plus 20. Okay? Now, we can observe that we have here this point and this point as our critical point. This point is actually the first point that we have solved, which is negative 125. Okay, we could verify it here. This is negative 1 and that would be 25. Negative 1, 25. Now, this next point is our second point that we have to solve, which is 3, negative 7. 3, negative 7. Okay, so what can we say about this point? Or particularly, what does it mean when I say y prime is equal to 0? And dun papasok, that's the time that I can introduce to you the concept of maxima and minima. Okay, so let's go back here. Y prime is equal to 0. What does that tell us? We know that the first derivative, okay, the first derivative is your slope. Okay, that is equal to the slope of the curve at any given point. Okay, so if we have solved for the first derivative, which we have did a while ago, then that is the slope. And since we have equated the slope or the first derivative to 0, so therefore we are solving for the points, okay, we are solving for the points where the slope is 0. Okay, so as you can see here, both points, negative 125 and negative 37, okay, has a slope of 0. Okay, when you have a slope of 0, then therefore, that equates to a horizontal line. Okay, that equates to a horizontal line which is tangent to this point. And you can clearly see that, no? I could draw a horizontal line at negative 125 and also at negative 37. And both of them will be tangent to the graph at that particular point. Okay, so the question now is, how do you determine what is the maxima and what is the minima? Now, by definition, now let's read that here. At a point where the function is algebraically greater than any point, okay, than any point, the function is said to have a maximum value, or that is the maxima. And similarly, the point that would have a lesser value than any neighboring point is said to have a minimum value or the minima. So on some references, the maximum value is also called the maximum point and the minimum value is also called the minimum point. So let us examine what we have here. At negative 125, it perfectly fits the definition here that negative 125 has a value that is greater than any neighboring point. Okay, it has a y value, 25, that is greater than any of the neighboring point on this function. And similarly, if you examine 3, negative 7, okay, negative 7 has a value which is lesser than any of the neighboring points here. Okay, so here and here. Okay, so therefore, we will say that negative 125 is your maximum point. That's the maximum point of the function. Okay, or the maxima. And 3, negative 7 is your minima. Now, how do we determine these two points? Okay, how do we know? When we have solved the critical point, how do we know that that is the maxima and that is the minima? Okay, without mathematically, no, without graphing. So the answer to that is you would have to get the second derivative. Okay, so let us examine again the graph that we have. So this is the graph. Okay, this is the maximum point. This is negative 125 and this is the minimum point, which is negative 3, negative 7. Okay, now as I've said, we will use the second derivative. Okay, the second derivative to mathematically prove what is the maximum point and what is the minimum point. Okay, so the concept of this one is first examine, okay, first let's just establish that the second derivative is the change of slope. Okay, the change of the slope. Okay, the first derivative is the slope. The second derivative is the change of slope. Now, if you will examine the slope here at the maximum point, no, the slopes, no, before and after this particular point, negative 125, what can we conclude? Okay, let's say for example, at this point, okay, if we draw a tangent line, that tangent line is the slope at that point, okay, it would be a line that is leaning towards the right. Okay, now if we draw or if we examine again another point here after this point, okay, it would be a line which is leaning towards the left. Okay, now if a line is leaning towards the right, we already know from our knowledge of analytic geometry that the slope of this line is positive. Okay, and from also analytic geometry, a line which is leaning towards the left would have a slope which is negative. Okay, so therefore the slope changes from positive to negative. So if we get the second derivative, and if the second derivative is negative, then therefore, that is a maximum point. Maximum point. Okay? Now, in contrast, okay, as we examine this minimum point here, okay, we select a point, we select any point before this point, and we can draw a line which is leaning towards the left. So therefore, the slope of that particular line would be negative. Now, if we select again another point, which is after the maximum point, and we draw a tangent line, okay, or give my tangent line, we can see that this line is leaning towards the right. So therefore, the slope of that particular line and the slope at this point is positive. So another conclusion can be made that if y double prime is positive, therefore we are dealing with the minimum point, or we are actually looking at the minimum point. So let us continue our example with this in this particular curve. Okay, we know that this curve is actually y is equal to x cubed minus 3x squared minus 9x plus 20. And we have solved for its first derivative. And the first derivative is actually 3x squared minus 6x minus 9. So let us apply this particular concept, okay, that I have discussed. And let us determine what is the maximum and the minimum point. So if we get the second derivative, we will have 6x minus 6. Now, to do the test, first substitute, okay, let us first examine negative 125. So, at x is equal to negative 1, okay, y double prime would be equal to 6 times negative 1 minus 6. So, we will have negative 6 minus 6, so that would be negative 12. So, since this is the 12 here doesn't matter. The only thing that matters here is the negative sign. Okay? Since this is a negative number, then therefore, this is your maximum point. Okay? So, that is how you will mathematically prove what is the maximum and what is the minimum point. Now, let us continue at x is equal to 3. Okay, at x is equal to 3, we get our second derivative, y double prime is 6x minus 6. Y double prime is 6 times 3 minus 6. So therefore, our y double prime is equal to 12. Okay, and since this is a positive number, then therefore, this would be the minimum point. Okay, I hope that's clear. And let's have another example. So we have the function y is equal to 2 plus 12x minus x cubed. So let us determine the critical points. Okay, and assign, okay, or determine if the critical point is actually a maximum point or a minimum point. Okay, and then determine whether maximum or minimum. Okay, so first, the first step, okay, the first step that you are going to do is to get the first derivative. Okay, solve for y prime. Okay, so y prime for this function, so we have y prime would be equal to, so derivative of 2 is 0, 12x is 12 minus 3x squared. And then after that, step number 2 is set y prime would be equal to 0. Okay, so set this to 0. So 0 would be equal to 12 minus 3x squared, and then solve for x. So let us include that in step 2. Solve for x. Okay, solve for the value of x. So we'll have 3x squared is equal to 12. So if we divide 3, we'll have x squared is equal to 4. And if we do square root of 4, we would arrive at positive and negative 2. Okay, so we'll have two values. First, x is 2. And then the other one, x is negative 2. So after that step, okay, after step 2, we go now to our step 3. And our step 3 is to determine the y value. Okay, solve for y. Okay, solve for y for the values of x. So sometimes isang x lang yung makukuha nyo dyan. Not all the times that you'll have 2. Okay, 2 critical points. Sometimes it's 3. Sometimes it's only 1. Okay. So, like for example, for a parabola, it only has one critical point. Okay? So, here we have two critical points. So, first, we have x is equal to 2. Okay? At x is equal to 2, so get your original function. Your original function is y is equal to 2 plus 12x minus x cubed. So, at x is equal to 2, y is equal to 2 plus 12 times 2. Minus 2 cubed. So y is equal to 2 plus 24 minus 8. So therefore we'll have here 2 plus 24, so that's 26. And we'll have y is equal to 18. So the first point, okay, the first critical point is 2 and 18. So next, okay, so I must add here solve for y to determine the critical points. Okay? So, next critical point is x is equal to negative 2. So, when x is equal to negative 2, so we'll have y is equal to 2 plus 12 times negative 2 minus negative 2 cubed. Okay? So, y is equal to 2 minus 24. And then this will be negative 8, tapos may negative doon, so therefore this will be positive 8. So we have 2 plus 8, that is 10, so therefore minus 24, so we'll have negative 14. So therefore, the next critical point would be negative 2 and negative 14. So between these two points, we will now go to the next step in determining what would be the maximum point and what would be the minimum point. So we go to step 4, okay? Step 4, which is apply the second derivative test. Apply second derivative to know whether or to know what would be the point that would be your maximum and what would be your minimum point. Okay, so again, let us review our statement for the second derivative. If y double prime is negative, then we are talking about a maximum point. Okay? Then if y double prime is positive, then we are talking about a minimum point. Okay? So we have solved for the first derivative, and the first derivative is equal to 12 minus 3x squared. Okay? So y prime is equal to 12 minus 3x squared. Therefore, the second derivative is simply 6x. Okay? So first, at x is equal to 2, and here at x is equal to negative 2. Okay? So at x is equal to 2, so y double prime is equal to negative 6x, so negative 6 times 2, and we will have a negative value, negative 12. So therefore, 218, okay, I'll just write it here, at x is equal to 2, which is 218, that would be your maximum point. And at x is equal to negative 2, okay, y double prime would be equal to negative 6 times negative 2. So therefore, y double prime is positive 12, no? Positive. So therefore, this particular point is your minimum point. Okay? So that is 4 simple steps on how to determine the critical points. So if you are asked, what are the critical points? So let us just summarize it here. The critical points are, okay, 218 and negative 2, negative 14. And then if you are asked what is the maximum point, then the answer is 218. What is the minimum point? Then the answer is negative 2, negative 14. And you can always confirm that if you have if you will graph your function, okay, I'll paste it here. So this is the function, okay, this is your function, which is 12, okay, y is equal to, that is y is equal to 12 plus, or 2 rather, 2 plus 12x minus x cubed. And we can see here your maximum point. So that maximum point is your 218. Okay, 218. And we have here your minimum point, which is negative 2, negative 14. Okay, so you can always confirm your answer using a grapher. So I hope you have learned something in watching this video regarding the critical points and identifying which is the maximum and the minimum point. Thank you for watching.